Welcome everybody here to your coverage of the Bigpoint Battle. While it's been a bit of a rough time on the scene that is Twitch TV, the live stream is up and running and we are good to go for the Bigpoint Battle today. Even if we weren't good to go with the live stream, we'll still make sure you get your VODs over on youtube.com/joinDOTA so you can watch all of these games, be it live or be it actually a little bit later for all those people out there that can't be awake at this time of the night. But for people who are, let's jump ourselves in directly to our draft. We're going to have Fnatic going up against GT Multi in our first game. So our first game, we will be doing our wonderful, wonderful Bigpoint Battle. If you don't know about the Bigpoint Battle, you can head yourself over to bigpoint-battle.com and you'll find out all the information you want to find for it over there. As far as the grid goes, actually got ourselves some really cool teams in this competition. Now, obviously, a lot of the teams are very busy with their different preparations, so as we kind of a little bit more used to here for the defense, we do like not have all of the top teams out there, but we do actually have a couple of the TI invite teams. As I said, if you want to see the details, head yourself over to bigpoint-battle.com. But as far as the seeded teams and the teams which you'll be wanting to keep your eyes peeled for, Fnatic EU is the team we're watching right now. Empire will also be in the mix-up. Looking forward to seeing if they can find their form and get us a matchup of Fnatic versus Empire. Look forward to that game. Roskis going up against the international version of Pain. Lions Pride also managed to get themselves in there with TM. Kaipia, they're having themselves a good time again down the bottom part of the bracket. Arctic and Flipside, possibly the hardest matchup out of all of these matchups in the first rounds, and they will be playing up, and we will be streaming that match second. The first rounds are being started with a bit of a break between them all, so you will get yourself to the match. Also, just checking some couple of details. Today, to start with, I'll probably be casting alone. Unfortunately, a lot of the other boys are already busy for today. But hopefully, I will be having myself a little bit of a friend to come and join me. And also, I kind of feel very, like, even more lonely because I don't have you guys. I don't have you guys. The Twitch TV chat is not working right now. The funny thing is, though, the live stream is 100% smooth. 100% smooth, which for me actually doesn't always happen, but hey, it's happening this time in Germany, so maybe all those fantastic servers that Twitch TV were going to plug in for the Europeans has managed to arrive. Awesome. Fantastic. Okay, cool. I just got the information too, so I was right. I was right about what's going on with tonight. So all the matches are best of ones. Of course, like a lot of people remember, like we used to do like best of three kind of style and things like that. They're doing best of ones. We split up the matches as well. So there's actually four matches going on right now. You can check out which games are being live streamed over on joinDOTA.com in the live and upcoming thing. But we've got Fnatic vs. GT starting up now. Empire is playing up against OSG. IC Cup up against NBCD. And SKZ versus CD as well. Coming up at 19 CET will be two games. We'll actually be doing the winners of this first part. So we do the upper portion of the bracket to start with, and then we jump to the lower portion of the bracket, doing the round of 16 matches there, and then doing the quarterfinal matches for that one. So that is the schedule coming up for you tonight. So that explains too why you might get a little bit confused looking over at joinDOTA.com, where it actually looks like there's a 2-hour break. It's not actually the case. So we'll actually follow the winner of this game through into the next game. That is the plan, which will be happening. But let's look at this game. I've spent enough time talking about all the other things happening around this, and we're almost finished the draft, which I think some of you back at home might actually be happy about. Because we're going to have Batrider, we've got Gyro Treant, as well as Puck being removed from the lineup. Lifestealer and as well as Wisp being banned out in their first two sets. So GT, they're trying to bait through one, and of course they managed to get themselves the Darkseer up for their use, and that is definitely going to help them out noishly when you consider, obviously, Initiation. But then again, the coupling with it isn't absolutely amazing. Like, obviously, you got Mana Void from the Animage, which can do some, but picking that target out in the middle of the team fight when you've got them all vacked into one position, very difficult to find the one on lowest mana and to use him. Nyx Assassin leaves his stun will couple up with the Darkseer. They still need someone else, though, for that pull-in. In fact, I think Fnatic would prefer to have that pull-in more than anything else right now. But they went with a Naga Ultimate, Disruptor combo. Jakiro will be there for the Macropire, Ice Path, and Prophet as well. So it's a high level of control coming off from Fnatic. But they still miss the deeps. Naga Siren with farm, then they'll have the DPS they require. but they need to get that Naga Siren farm. Without it, it's just they don't have anything. Prophet, Trixie, of course, we have seen him in the past go with a lot more like a damaging style build. You can go with that early Shadow Blade, go into the Desolator as well. Helps you push out towers, but also helps you with like those heroes which you just take forever to get down. Early Roshan's, that negative armor effect definitely helps you on your way to victory. So we'll see. We will see how everything will go down with this. So Templar Assassin will be the last man out by Flyer. So he's looking towards that middle lane. Interested to see also what Fnatic want to run there, because they could be thinking, yeah, up against an SD and Nyx Assassin, they probably won't want to run aggressive tri-lane, but up against an Anti-Mage, they may consider it. The Disruptor's just too weak in lane, so I would assume that Fnatic would be going up for that top lane, trying to run Trixie as an Aegis Prophet on the long lane. Very dangerous lane from him. In fact, I would probably say from the very, very start that that lane will be sacked. They won't want to follow up with that one. And they actually go with the Dazzle. Okay, so Dazzle here from Fnatic Fly. Gonna give this one a shot. Remember, this is a best of one, and they're missing a very hard counter to the Anti-Mage, but the Dazzle is also an enabler. The question I have right now is, actually, it shouldn't be a question. It's not Jakiro in the middle lane, it's not Disruptor. They're both supports. We're looking at core Dazzle coming off from Fnatic. It's the only logical option right now. So Dazzle will be running middle lane, would be an assumption, unless they're feeling they want to throw him on the long lane and put Prophet in towards that middle lane. They could be running him as a solo top. Up against the Darkseer, it's not a bad option. Because then Darkseer's harassment damage really counts for nothing. And his pushing of the creep wave also won't 100% work, because you've got Dazzle's heal, which will not only damage down the enemy creep wave, but also heal up his own. So maybe this is their testing ground to see how it goes up against the Darkseer. Which means if Darkseer is long lane, Anti-Mage, SD, Nyx Assassin, 10 seconds. They're not going to run aggressive with that one, which means Dazzle's actually got to go. Nice last pickup. So whoever tries to go the middle, it's actually going to be Dazzle mid. It's got to be Dazzle mid now. Prophet long lane. It just doesn't work with anything else. They can't run a Disruptor in an aggressive trial lane. Not up against the two supports, which are currently there. So they'll have to try something else. Hopefully everyone's live streams are also working very, very nicely. I have a perfectly smooth live stream over on my side here from inside of Berlin, but because I know that doesn't really count for much when there's so many different things that go together to get a live stream out there. But we will be looking to hopefully have Twitch TV come back into its former self. Get that text up and running. Because I miss the chat. I really miss the chat. I want to interact with you guys, and I'm missing the chat. I miss you. I miss you with an affection which shall be spoken. I'm speaking it right now. All right, let's get ourselves in, boys. Let's get ourselves in. Unfortunately, whoops, Capitalist not with me today. Maybe later on tonight. We'll run through our lineup, so we'll have Hani. So it will be a solo mid-Dazzle. What the hell has he done to his face? The fetish of feather spirits. Okay, go the feather spirits. All right, so it will be Hani for a solo mid Dazzle. Trixie long lane, no tell safe lane, Era as well, Fly gonna be supporting him, and that's gonna be Disruptor, Naga and Jakiro together. As far as the lineup coming up here from GTM, I actually know very little about this team. This is actually one of the first times, in fact, I believe it is the first time that GTM have competed in any tournament for joinDOTA. For everything we run, they haven't actually flagged in our system just yet. Okay, let's stop reading Skype. So I'm also trying to help out a couple of other people that are trying to get their streams up and running. Because obviously, for people who don't know, while joinDOTA is a part of Freaks for You, there's a lot of other live streams going off right now. So I know Jason's having himself some fun. Same with Maury. For our StarCraft 2 stream, I believe Jason's doing, well, he'll either be doing LOL or we'll be doing Counter-Strike tonight. So, multitasking it up, peoples. Multitasking it up. Alright, so we're good to go. We need some tactics. Is he trying to... No. It is tactics. I don't know why I read it as tactics. Wow. I need it. It must be because I'm still planning. I'm planning a holiday, peoples. Yeah, that's right. There's going to be a two-week period sometime in the unknown future where I will disappear from the internet world. I hope you can all deal with that. I'm hoping I can deal with it. I'm going to go on a trip around Australia and New Zealand is the plan. Go back to my country. Haven't been there for 2 years, so it'll be fun. Anyway, fun right now here in the Big Point. We'll be having SD making his way out, Observers and Sentry, so already preparing for this rotation movement that can come from both Disruptor and Jakiro. And then you look through the rest of the lineup. I am not even going to try and pronounce him, but we're gonna call him Rusky. Rusky will be the anti-mage on the bottom lane. Carmen right behind him as the Nyx Assassin. Skeddy Dog, the Dark Seer, that puts the Shade as the Warlock. And then, I don't know why I read that as Elka History. Zell. We're going to call him Zell. That works. Smoke movement. Very interesting movement as well. It's almost like they think that this is a level 1 Roshan. They just caught a glimpse of the Disruptor walking up. Yeah, I got a funny feeling they think this is a level 1 Roshan. They smoke in, they have a check. Yep, they realize that Roshan's not going on. With the Dazzler Tree Protector and the Naga images, I wouldn't put against Fnatic for giving it a shot, but it would have taken them a hell of a lot longer than this. Like, they don't have a great level 1 DPS. Like, you're 52 base damage up on the Naga Siren. That's not really a hell of a lot to play with in the early stages. Even with Trixie's small army of trees and the Naga images, obviously they can't attack. But what they can do is sit there in front of Roshan and just tank up the hits from Roshan. Doesn't buy you a hell of a lot, but it's something. Well, they could have just tried to use the Riptide instead. Either way you look at it, level 1 Roshan was never going to really happen here for Fnatic. They wouldn't have even wanted to try and contest a level 1 fight. So we'll see how Harney now goes in the middle lane up against Warlock. Of course, Warlock, he'll enjoy this lane. This is not a lane he'll really be too concerned about. Both heroes here in the middle lane have abilities to heal themselves up as well as damage down their opponents. Of course, it requires Warlock to come in close for that to happen, though. So you have to watch that one closely. And then, of course, you do this. So, Harney, he won't really care about this. In fact, his pickup is almost perfect up against a Warlock. His creep wave's getting hurt. He's getting hurt. Bit by bit, things are just, like, not going his way here. But you then pull up, like, Poison Touch, so he wants to be aggressive to the Warlock, as well as having that Shadow Wave, making it almost impossible for Shade to kill him off. Especially once he gets his higher levels, probably see him level up, maybe not even level up Shallow Grave. If he gets too concerned about some things, then maybe he will. But right now, there is nothing to be for him to have of major concern. Like, he's dropping low, he needs more heal. He kind of needs his bottle in that middle lane, but he's trying to get that creep wave down so then he can do that. Let's try and Shadow Wave it down, get that level up, and there's that second level. Meanwhile, on the bottom lane, Shadow Demon. Trying to have a bit of a gank there on Trixie. The line was actually already been drawn out there. That one came out by the SD saying he wanted to rotate in and try and find this kill on Trixie because they know all they need is a disruption. A disruption with a follow-up impale, and they can do a hell of a lot of damage to Trixie. But Trixie, the wise thing, pulls the creep wave back past the tower. And when you're up this deep, the possibility of getting yourself out if you're committing that far is very, very low. A rotation from a Shadow Priest, you can have TPs that can come in from the Disruptor any time, and he will have Glimpse and Wall up and running. So if Anime tries to blink himself away, it won't be as possible. But then again, Glimpse is pretty low on range right now. It's obviously not the highest level out there. Whoop, Darkseer. With the double damage up on Harney, there was no way you want to fight that one, especially once that Poison Touch started to really hurt him down. 44 life points. This is actually Skeddy Dog now has to walk all the way back to base. Misses out on the rune control and has to retreat himself back again. And Harney, man, you can see him. He's lapping this one up. He knows now he could be the aggressor and force Warlock just to push himself back. No more of this, like, I say no more of this Fatal Bonds, but he can at least control it a hell of a lot more and bring Shade down. But Shade's now running his bottle, but so was Harney. Because when he picked up that double damage, that gave him a whole new bottle charge. So rune control is going to be so important for both these players here in the middle lane. They're going to need every single one of these bottle charges. In fact, whoa, Hani. This is really dangerous for him. Overcommitted himself. There was actually that small moment of hesitation. It was right here when he stopped. And you know the reason why is because these guys were coming in, no tail and fly. I think Hani really thought he could keep himself alive in that and use himself as bait. Instead now, he gives away the first blood to Shade, but they'll look for a revenge kill. Warlock, wall is up. That'll hold him there for a little bit. Dual breath, ice path. Hold him as long as possible. No-Tail's going to have to glimpse him back in again, so they've got more time to attack on him. So there will be a revenge kill, and that was what was supposed to happen the first time. But Hani overcommitted himself. So it becomes 1-1 up on the board. How's the rest of our lanes looking? Naga, free farm top lane. Look at her counterpart in the bottom lane, the Animage, 21-7. Not looking too bad there on Rusky. Has to come with the rolled R, people. Has to come with the rolled R. And got a little bit of change up. Darkseer finally now going to enter this top lane. Soul Ring Recipe with the Ring of Regen, so he's going to hope that he's able to get some last hits out from this one. And the second he arrives, Era denies two creeps in almost instantly. And he knows. He knows the Skeddy Dog has come up. The Skeddy Dog, nice little movement up and down, but he doesn't have boots. And with the Arcane Boots of Era, he can do a hell of a lot of damage. And Snare, oh, he's not really going to do it. He just wants to force Darkseer out of experience range. Meanwhile, in the middle lane, it's like Warlock throwing down the ulti and the Fatal Bonds. Hani, he wants to heal them all up again. And it's probably like, No-Tail, do you want to come down? Nope. Both popping off the cells. There's no creep wave that still has the Fatal Bond that's attached to it. So life is fine there, but Hani being chased out by this Warlock Golem. Now Disruptor. Nice level up on Glimpse. 2 points on that one. Has a good range with that Warlock. Really starting to burn them down. They've got to split themselves up. Hani taking so much damage because Fly was getting hit then. And they've got to get it off that creep. There we go. Finally the heal comes in. There was that one creep that was being damaged down that could have actually brought them to death. And Scaredy Dog, he wants a kill here. Gonna surge himself up, but he has no Iron Shell. He has no nothing to play around with. So while the intentions are good to get a kill here, he basically requires himself to be level 9 to be capable of doing such a thing. 4-point Iron Shell, 2-point Surge, 1-point Vac, that will probably be enough to do it. But not gonna happen, but what they are gonna do is smoke move. So this will be gank for the middle lane. That is the plan. Also just double checking, looks like our live stream is actually still up and running perfectly. Wunderbar! Das ist richtig gut, da? Yeah, as you can see, my German still has a lot of work to do on it. Hani, nice. Very nicely done. Disruption, follow-up stun, and Hani couldn't get the heal off in time. And as I was talking about beforehand, like, I know I've been focusing a lot on Hani in the middle lane, but it's because I wanna just try and focus on how successful this Dazzle pick is or isn't. Whenever teams are trying new things like this, you always want to, like, commit it to memory. This is one of those things where, like, Bigpoint Battle, compared to all the other competitions out there, you look at the competition, you say, oh, okay, like, it's a smaller cup, but that's also a great thing because then it's open to new teams and experimentation from some of the top teams. And with experimentation in a competitive setting, that's when you learn so much more as the commentator. So I like watching this. Like, this bottom lane matchup, this is pretty standard for Trixie. The only interesting thing, actually, is for Trixie, is he's just going straight ahead of Midas. He went with a Ring of Basilius, and that's going to set him back a little bit. There's no boots for a hero, though, that's on a long lane. Fnatic is a group that likes to run boots on any kind of hero that runs a long lane. Ever see those Batriders come in? They'll pull in resources and make sure he's got boots. They make sure there's maneuverability coming off. And now Poison Touch. Already starting off, Warlock, nice Alderman, follows up with a Fate Bolt, and that helped No-Tail as well as Hani out, but they want to find this one. Hani, he's still going to heal up his sleeve, and they're doing a lot of damage there, the Warlock, but there's no one else near him that can cop this damage. And Hani just copying a couple of too many hits there. Trying to heal himself up while the Poison also scouting off for No-Tail. Throws down a Sentry. If he walks up to that high ground, that Sentry will be in range to see the Observer Ward of the Radiant side. But he has no Observer Ward himself up there. In fact, no Observer Ward in inventory. So he can't have the battle of vision. Dire's middle tower is under attack. Fly just babysitting that DD rune. Hani would love to pick that one up. Is he going to give a bottle charge over? Yeah, he does. Gives it to Notel. Who uses the entire bottle to get himself back up to full health and mana. Because he can bottle up the DD rune here. That bottle does belong to Hani, but as long as he doesn't give the bottle over, that's fine. So he'll pop the DD. Should be popping that DD because there's more support coming in. And Shade, oh, Disruption, Ice Path actually catching out two of the heroes right now. They're trying to get themselves in close. That heal will do his job at the same time. Susceptible to a Fae Bolt. And Shade, well, ticks out from the Dazzle's Poison Touch. Problem is, Disruptor went down while he's still got the DD rune inside Hani's bottle. So Hani doesn't have his bottle back again. Scaredy Dog will show himself here in the middle lane. Oh, wow. Too far up, SD. No mana for Disruption. Also, Trixie has level 6 now. As proving through the ulti, flying from the bottom lane all the way into the mid. And getting him a kill. So Fnatic will now focus on the tier 1 tower on the top lane. Or maybe they'll just go again on Scaredy Dog. Glimpse on cooldown. Can't use it, but that Thunderstrike really doing its job. Same with the Poison Touch. They're both combining up together. And Warlock trying to bring down Notel. Prophet. Oh, hello, Trixie. Sprouts in. There's a glimpse. That probably wasn't actually the plan. Notel did it so he'd live. That was the main reason why he did that. But at the same time, eh. Warlock goes down. Well, Warlock goes back. Radiant's top tower. So just TPing back in again. You can never do that on top of a tower. Era. He's got Naga ulti. He should... Ensnare. And he's just too far away. It was a trap. It's a trap. All they want to do is kill up the Darkseer. Back hitting it. Doing a lot of damage there to Era. The tower will be destroyed by Jakiro. And now Era may as well just pop his ulti. Got to get himself out of here. Oh no, they fight it. That dual breath that came out from Fly. It was enough to get the kill out in the Darkseer. Now the Ensnare. It's holding the Nyx Assassin in position. He's actually dying. Right now, the Naga illusions that are in this fight, Fly, he's still on low light. There is no way that both these heroes can survive. Era wants back in again with a Riptide in the last... Yeah, he does. He gives himself a double kill. Jakiro for 3, basically. Naga takes Nyx. Shadow Demon takes Jakiro. So 3 going down overall, but it's still a 2-for-1 trade. Dire's bottom tower is under attack. Now, haste rune on Hani. Easy to chase down the Warlock, especially when Warlock is brought straight back to you. So Warlock, he's got ulti, he doesn't want to throw it. He wants to save it this time around, but no, there's teammates coming in. So throw down the ulti, already the Fatal Bond's going, and there's your Shallow Grave. The problem is, Hani, he's going to be killing off Notel while he continues to take this damage. So he heals himself up, the Ice Bath, it keeps Getty Dog away, and then he turns for the Poison Touch. The Macro Pyre is out. Able to help burn down whatever they can find. They want to find more. Hani, he's low on mana, but with one last heal to give, Notel was just out of range for that one. He'll have to pop his 6 stick charges, and Shadow Demon pops up his stick charges, realizing Era's on his way in. Near images up, Ice Path will hold him there. No follow-up for any kind of ability. At the same time, Nyx Assassin can snipe out Notel, or tries to. Notel! Down to 6 HP! And the poison just gets to hold him there. And keep Notel alive. And Hani's like, well, if I had mana, man, I would do something for you. But I got no mana. You got no life points. A 12-minute rune may save us a little bit. And they got one Observer Ward watching that top rune. And it's not going to be there. In fact, it is a regeneration. It is a regeneration. Perfect, in fact, for Notel. But Hani wants the bottle charges. I'm interested to see how they're going to approach this one. Hani needs mana, so he'll pick it up. He can't just give the bottle over. The regeneration room will not work if he does such a thing. So instead, he's just going to try and heal Notel up the old-fashioned way and maybe just send Notel back. Smoke time. Oh, they could just wait for that. Mech just flew in. 12 and a half minute mech. Coming the way of Fnatic. And now they'll go on to the tier one tower amid disruption on the back lines. It's just getting a copy of Trixie, but Trixie's still got ulti up and running too. Tether Bonds attaching to Era. But that's all. The rest of Fnatic is free to move as they wish. And then Glimpse Wall up and Warlock caught. No ultimate available because he threw it out before. Ice Path also will continue to hold him there for just a little bit longer as they attack uphill. Couple of misses, but still they get the kill. And Hani, well, sticking with Cartman, but Cartman has to use the Vendetta defensively, which is not his desire. We got Sentry Wards. Yeah, 2 over on Jakiro.
as
well. In the meantime, Animage is still farming up in the bottom lane, already has his Battle Fury, so he's doing a really good job of finding his CS. In fact, most amount of CS on the map. The problem is he still must control the map. Having a Battle Fury in Animage, while it's great, it's not the be-all end-all of Alakazam. He still can't fight right now, hasn't finished up his trades. If he jumps into this fight, he's dead instantly. And Fnatic know this. This is the reason why they're forcing this. New creep wave comes in, they lose a tier 1 tower to the Animage in the bottom lane. There should now be the AMT being back to get his treads. In fact, there it goes, while the Ice Bath also up. They're trying to get a kill off on Nyx Assassin. Fatal Bond's tying all Fnatic together, but they think they can get themselves a kill. Warlock, well, he's got an ultimate. He's going to throw it down, and there she goes on all five Furies of Fnatic. They've got to back themselves out. AMR, he went on No-Tail. Or did he actually? It almost like he did that on Trixie. And Trixie has full mana right now. So Trixie has no issue with that whatsoever. Well, Hani keeps him alive. Even already has 2 points now up on his ultimate. So he'll have the armor bonus. In fact, there you see it. It'll start ticking up. +5, +6. Even killing up a Jakiro right now is difficult. Ensnare, follow up Ice Path. Riptide wants to happen. Nyx Assassin, nice stun. The ulti from Disruptor. Obviously, you can't stop Nyx Assassin from casting off abilities. Nesty goes into his disruption. Getting copies of Era, trying to force him back. Era now, with all the money, in fact, has bought up a Diffusal Blade. But to them, at this point, doesn't matter. What they want is that mid-tier 3 tower. They want it down so they can keep breaking the base. Hani, he's on low life, a low mana. But that mana boy is still 15 seconds. Nice, Sprout! Holding out both Shade as well as Scaredy Dog. Scaredy Dog able to back it back in again. He's only level 8 while this fight's going on. Fnatic, they consistently keep pushing at the base, and now we've got the armor change happening. Animage has absolutely no armor whatsoever. It's a level 2 ultimate from the Dazzle. They try and fight that. The armor difference is insane. +15, +18, +19, +20. Up on the Prophet at the end of all of that. And with all these kills going their way because they've got this huge advantage, they will be able to take up this Rax AM, try jump out of No-Tail. But again, as I said, not enough life points when he jumps in, even with that belt. Hey, Vendetta kill. Able to finally snipe off that Disruptor. And Trixie as well. Darkseer helping him out, having that Iron Shell on him. And now Fnatic, they've lost a couple of heroes. Prophet said screw this, buying back, taking T1 tower bottom lane. Or is he? The Pink's coming out to come back in towards the middle lane. Nice back, but he's still going to go down. At least now up to level 9, so he's got that 3-point back. Maybe it would have been better to have 1 point up on that wall, even just as a deterrent. Level 2 wall is what you kind of need during a fight. Level 1 wall is a little bit, yeah. But they need something to deter Fnatic. You throw a wall right across this line, Fnatic won't just walk through it. I'll have to deal with illusions. I'll have to deal with things like Naga Siren, with Diffuser Blade. Just normal attacks coming out from everybody else, which is, eh. Fly almost feels like bait here in the middle lane. I would say he is, because you can have Prophet just come in. Yeah, Naga. She's ready as well. So both the supports showing themselves. Still haven't seen a single Naga ultimate yet. Era, well, he's going to find another one. Ensnare down the Darkseer. Even if he tries to surge, it's not going to help me. You see Era, he body blocks him in. Move to the other side after popping up the mirror images so he can't run out through the tree line, which means Trixie now can follow up. Diffuse the blade over onto the SD, slows him down, burns him up. And Era picks up a double kill. And then back into the Weave again. Catching every single one of the Fnatic heroes up. Disruption, Glimpse, too easy. Disruptor Glimpse it was. And now they'll take the mid. They can't take another Rax though. But with the momentum of this middle lane, you know, they'll just move out and probably look to the tier 2 tower bottom lane. There is problem up on the top lane. Animage has basically given up and trying to defend that middle lane. It's just left him to go farm up that top. You're already seeing No-Tail trying to come down there to help him push it out. Fnatic are picking up any buildings they possibly can. All those Moonwells. Oh, they're going to attempt a Rock's Kiss here. The problem for their attempt of a Rock's Kiss is they never really went out. Trixie's going to DC out for a moment. I like this warding as well. Even if GT multi, like this is a really rough matchup for them. You look at it and you say, well, what do we really do to deserve Fnatic? Fnatic is our first opponent. If you look through all of the opponents here in the Bigpoint Battle, Fnatic is the top one. They really are almost numbered like numero uno. So they really have themselves a rough troll, but they're still fighting it out. They're still doing what they can. They throw down a sentry ward here in the middle lane. Which means now they can de-ward off that observer ward too. They're trying to just make sure there's no extra vision inside that base. And there's a reconnect by Prophet. But they've got to give this anti-mage more time. Kind of seems crazy, but he's got treads up, he's got his battle fury up and running. If he's able to get a mana style up and running as well, I know it's a long ask, but when it's 1.1k into it, there is that possibility that it will work. But that means I need time. And Era still hasn't popped an ultimate. I don't know if this is like something he's trying to do. To not pop an ultimate. Either way. Bottom tier 2 tower now be brought down. There will be nothing that will stop this. They gotta defend from their own high ground. And now Animage, yeah, he does have to come back. And he goes into an Ogre Club. So we're not gonna see damage, we're seeing trying to see stability coming off with an Ogre Club. Just life points for now. I wouldn't even think he's sticking at a BKB or something beyond that. He just wants to jump in there and live longer than a second. Now the VAC, well, it won't happen. But wonderful Oli from Disruptor. There goes your VAC pulling Trixie up with the macro pyre. Darkseer is just burning in this one. Same with SD. And Darkseer will finally go down coming out of that disruption. Bias back into the game. There's still Fatal Bonds connecting all Fnatic together. But while they've got this mech as well as that wave coming out, it's too much. Shallow Grave goes up on Notel just in case anyone was sick about nuking him down. But it's just, yep, run away. And someone bought up a Yule Scepter. Naga also down with her ulti. That's just a really unfortunate position. It was the... Oh! They lost their courier. There was nothing on it, though. Must be when it delivered off that Yule Scepter over to Hani. That's an interesting combination. With the Yule Scepter, try and search yourself away. Always got it. This is now GG. The bottom tower will go down. They will take out the rags, and Fnatic will have themselves a little bit more fun before we end this up. Coming up in the next games, though, guys, we will be looking to follow the winner of this match, Fnatic, going up against either Empire or OSG. This game was pretty quick, so we'll probably have ourselves a little bit of a break. Oh, nice VAC! Really nice VAC! Into the AM ulti, that's some really good AoE damage. They're able to kill off at least the Jakiro. Problem is, Fnatic's just way too far ahead right now. Triple kill for Era. What is this going to end on? 13-0-11 for Era. He's really been finding his stride over the past couple of weeks. Having some tremendous results. Well, that Prophet Sprout's actually not going to help him until he does that. And there's still an ultra kill. So there's the GG. It's going to be the range race to go down, bottom lane to push in. And then tier 4 towers as well to follow after. Already got the super seismic creeps pushing up that middle lane. And they'll DC themselves out. Yeah, but we'll let you know about the result between Empire and OSG. The game's already started. I know a lot of people will probably be cheering for Empire on the sidelines. You got people like Light of Heaven, Scandal, Blow Your Brain, Screen, and Senfrit Dove. And they are the 5 players who are playing in that matchup against Ocelot Gaming. Because if you want to check out all the details about who's streaming out what games, you can do so. JoinDOTA.com, find the live and upcoming button. Now, if you want to follow all the details, the Bigpoint Battle, go to bigpoint-battle.com. You know, the links to all the little freebies too, which you can get. Game of the week today, it's Pirates! Because there'll be more action coming up. So we'll do the winner of this game up against the winner of either Empire or OSG. And then coming up after that one will be Arctic Gaming versus Flipside. And we'll probably also do exactly the same thing. Follow the winner through. Winner of that one goes up against the winner of Kaipi and Standin. They're still IC Cup and XKZ a little bit further down. They're playing their games up right now. So it's actually a little bit incorrect. We're saying we're doing the upper part of the bracket and the lower part of the bracket. We're actually doing the two extremes. So the top two games in the bracket and the bottom two games. And then we do the middle portion of it all. And we'll have our semi-finalists by the end of tonight. That is the goal. That is the plan, Stan. So stay tuned. If you want to be part of that plan, then all you got to do is stay on the live stream. We'll see you back here after what will be hopefully a short break. for the next point of the Bigpoint Battle. See you shortly.